There is a saying that humans are made in the image of God. Humans have spirits and minds, but I wonder if God also has a spirit and a mind. Humans are made in the image of God. Who said this? Some person said it. Someone clarified their expression by using a metaphor. And this has been passed down through history. That person expressed about God based on their understanding. God never said that. God exists by itself. I will teach you about God. God is the energy of heaven, earth, and nature. Nature itself is God. Then who am I? In grand nature, there are three kinds of energies. There are energies of heaven, earth, and humans. Human energy means I. Our souls residing in the physical body is called human energy. When it separates from the physical body, it becomes soul energy. Then what is it when it has never entered the human body? It is called an element. Elements of nature, the energy that exists by itself. However, it is called human energy when it enters the flesh. Element enters the body and becomes tarnished with thoughts and feelings. When it leaves the body, it becomes soul energy. Removed from the flesh, it becomes a soul, a spirit. We don't call it human energy. Our names change as we go through different phases. Next, we call the entire energies of heaven and earth God. It is called 천지신명. In Haedong Daeanmingguk, God was called 천지신명님. Some countries called it God. It was simply called 신, meaning spirit. It is originally God, and so people called it God or 신. Then how was the term heavenly God created? The term 하느님 was created after Christianity entered Joseon. Christian pastors and priests from the West brought the terminology God into Joseon. It was called God when it first came in. At that time, they called it God in both the West and Joseon Dynasty. But since they called it God, people in Korea asked what kind of God they were talking about. It is because in Joseon, gods usually meant ancestral gods when people said God. There were many different types of gods in Joseon, like 천지신명, ancestral gods, mountain gods, and seven-star gods. When Westerners said God, people asked what kind of God. This caused a lot of confusion. They couldn't answer what kind of God. The missionary said that it was a monotheistic God. What kind of God? All the gods are monotheistic in their own right. If you separate them into different classes, each god is the only god in their respective field. Someone in Joseon studied this and named it Han-ul or Han-eul. So people of Joseon worshipped Han-ul or Han-eul. So they named this monotheistic god 하늘님.
하늘님이라 하자. 요래 나왔던 거예요. 그래서 처음에는 하늘님이
In the beginning, 하늘님. God was called 하늘님, which means heavenly God. 하나, Over time, it has changed into the one and only God, 하나님.
조선에서 만들어준 겁니다.
This name was created in Joseon. So the term 하나님 or one God was created to embrace the Korean people. The international community doesn't know what you mean by 하나님 right now. They know it when you say God. But Koreans know what it means with 하나님. Therefore, this Almighty God, the God of heaven and earth, remains still while humans move. God exists on its own and protects itself. You are the ones to manage the world. As we are managing the world, there are also many gods who manage together. These are soul energy. All the gods that are spoken in the spiritual world, Zeus as an example, are soul gods. In certain times, specific nations created particular gods, but these gods were all their ancestors, their idols, and their heroes. People respected and admired heroes who had lived in such a heroic era, and so they became gods, and people tried to borrow power from them. So these were their ancestor gods. The god who has lived for itself is a solitary god, so he is a lowly god. So each type of god has their names. They lived by knowing only themselves. Let's say there is someone who couldn't get married, and so they died with resentment. Then they become Mongdal ghost. A bachelor ghost who died without getting married is Mongdal ghost. And there are wandering ghosts that just wander around. We don't call it a ghost, we call it 구신. Next, some people worked hard for their families and died. Then they are called ancestor gods. It is an ancestral god who is qualified to come to their family because they worked hard for their family. Someone like your uncle who didn't live for their family and who bragged arrogantly and died. Then he becomes a Mongdal ghost. Since they lived only knowing themselves and died, no one welcomes them. They can't agree. That's why they wander around. When those uncles come, that family struggles. They ask to join, but they can't join. Why? They can't join because they didn't put any effort at all. That's why they can't unite with the family and are always wandering around. When these ghosts intrude into your home, many accidents can happen. Next, there is a screaming grandmother who has been out of her family and working for the community. She died while meddling about everything in the neighborhood without worrying about her family. When these people die, they become Dangsan gods defending the village as the village's chief. Among the Dangsan gods, there are intelligent Dangsan gods and the wandering grandmother Dangsan gods. Like this, each Dangsan god is different. They are in one group of gods. Dangsan gods lived for their village. Next, some people lived by caring for a particular region. They lived in and cared for the mountains. So they become mountain gods. So the question is, how did you live your life? Like this, if someone lived for the sake of the country, whether others know it or not, if they died thinking of the country, instead of worrying about their family, then they will become a representative god of the country. If there is a war, they storm into battle to fight and protect the country and die. They become the representative gods of national defense. So what happens if we live for humanity? We will become the representative gods of the world who manages humanity. This is the process of becoming a god. When humans die, they become gods. So when you live purely for society as a human, the celestial world will choose you to take the role of the heavenly gods. This is God. You need to know God correctly. If you take away the flesh, you become a god. We were gods before we came to this world in the form of humans. Hongikingans, all of you whose reincarnation is over, are all the people who were the leaders of gods in the celestial realm. Gods have many jobs to do. There are many classifications of gods, and the gods who were heads of each class have come here now. In order to perform the great reconstruction of heaven and earth, you came to earth on your last human incarnation. What kind of resentments will you resolve? Benefiting people widely by contributing everything that you have will open the door to a new era. To do this, you have learned and developed by the blood and sweat of the people. If you don't think of the people and only care about your children, you will only become the ancestral gods. That can't happen. This is your last life. We must devote all of our lives to benefit people widely, and we have to benefit society and go, because we cannot come back with the body again. We will ascend to heaven as heavenly gods. You will rise to become a heavenly deity, not the head of representative gods. As a holy army, as a heavenly worker, you will end your life and ascend to heaven and become the heavenly representative gods. This is not the head representative gods. You will become the representative of the heavenly gods. We are living our last lives to make that happen. I am the chief leader who is leading those heavenly gods. I came into the world to lead the Hongikingans. That's why our last life is very precious. I will guide everyone to live their life in such a way. I will work to lead everyone toward that goal. Even if the stubborn people struggle along, I will show a path that has no other path than that path. I will steer everyone to join in and live to benefit people widely. If you don't go that path, you will suffer greatly and have no other choice but to follow. I will lead you. I am in charge of our last incarnation. Intellectuals must re-establish what is God. Until now, people called God with their own logic, and some asserted that they were children of God, all based on their logic. We are intellectuals. We are the best intellectuals of humanity. Regardless of how you develop yourselves, the best intellectuals in the history of humankind is only possible when you're living your last life on earth. The logic that these people are using to solve problems should be different. It is up to us to create a new order in this world. So we learned all kinds of logic in the world, but how are we going to solve the problem comprehensively? This was our mission. God is the energy of heaven, earth and nature, and we are the elements that are managing it. You are in the physical bodies now, but at the moment of separation, you will be the gods who must operate nature. The energy of heaven and earth stands still while humans move nature. You, the elements, run nature. you need to purify yourself, and when you return to our origin in grand nature with pure energy, grand nature will operate peacefully. So you must practice and purify yourself even if it's hard. That is our mission. That is why the heaven and earth were separated. There is no heaven and earth when we return to our origin. Those words are temporary terms. Do you understand?